Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create text made of animal fur. This is an update of a tutorial I did many years ago. This update is quicker and more efficient. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, click that small subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. I provided a link to a great set of animal fur brushes. The link is located in my video's description below or project files. If you're not sure how to install brushes, I provided a link to a tutorial that I did showing you how to do it. In addition, for your convenience, I provided a Photoshop document that you could download. It includes two layers, a photo of grass that we'll use for the background and a photo of fur. Feel free to use different images if you'd like. Just make sure they're 150 pixels per inch to ensure that the setting amounts that we'll be using for the filters will have the same result as mine. After you place the fur brush set in your Photoshop's brush folder of the presets folder, open your brush tool and brush picker. Click the gear icon and click Import Brushes. Click the brush set labeled SS Fur. Then click Load. At the bottom of the brush panel, you'll see the new fur brush set you loaded. Open the folder to see all the brushes within this set. For this particular project, I'm using the one labeled 004, but feel free to experiment with the others if you like. Go to Window and Brush Settings, or press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard. Since I already saved my brush settings earlier, I'll apply them to this brush by opening the Brushes panel and clicking it. In the Brush Tip Shape panel, temporarily make the size 135 pixels. You can always adjust this amount later based on the size of your text. The spacing is 1%. Click Shape Dynamics. The size jitter is 100% and all the controls are off. The minimum diameter is 100% and the angle jitter is 20%. The roundness jitter is 80%. The minimum roundness is 1% and check Flip X Jitter. Click Scattering. Scatter is 33% and check both axes. The control is rotation, and the count is 4. The count jitter is 100%, and the control is off. Check smoothing. Then close the panel. Make the fur layer active, and open your horizontal type tool. Open the type picker, and pick a very thin font. I'm using Verlag Extra Light. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll be using a large point size since I'll be typing out only 3 characters. The justification is centered. Click on your document and type out your text. To center it, open your Move tool and drag it. Go to an empty area of the fur layer and right-click or secondary click to open the Flyout List. Click Rasterize Type. Control-click or Command-click the text layer to make a selection of it. Open your Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Click the icon at the right to open the Flyout List and click Make Work Path. Keep the tolerance at its default of 0.5 pixels. Click the icon again and click Stroke Path. Make sure Brush is in the window and Simulate Pressure is unchecked. To hide the work path, click anywhere inside the Paths panel. Open back the Layers panel. We want to move the text layer below the fur texture. There are two ways to do this. We can either manually drag the text layer below the fur texture or use the shortcut Control or Command and the left bracket key. We're going to fill our text with the fur. To do this, make the fur layer active and press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. If you want to resize the fur texture inside your text, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you're using a version of Photoshop earlier than CC 2019, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. Then, press Enter or Return. To reposition the fur inside your text, just drag it. I'll undo it by pressing Ctrl or Command Z. Next, we'll add dimension to the fur. Double-click the fur layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 30 pixels, and the soften is 16 pixels. Global light is unchecked, the angle is 130 degrees, and the altitude is 20 degrees. The gloss contour is linear, the highlight mode is overlay, the color is white, and its opacity is 70%. The shadow mode is linear burn, the color is black, and its opacity is 30%. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is linear burn, the color is black, and the opacity is 30%. Global light is unchecked, and the angle is 135 degrees. The distance is 35 pixels, the spread is 0%, and the size is 0 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.